no breaks. About to jump on the KDM. Got our carburetor dialed in. Missing our back fender, like Ronnie Mac style. Let's see how this carburetor's doing. This is Tony Camp. We're just got the new jet in the carburetor. We're gonna test it out. We went to the 470 on the main jet. Much better. I feel a lot more comfortable with this jetting.
Guys, Clayton here today, and I picked up this new to me KTM. It's not really brand new or anything, but it's new to me, and I had a couple KTMs over the years. We always ran the Shell Rotella 15W40. As you can see, right down there is your drain for the oil. Right there, that's your drain, and the oil is 10 millimeter. That's the size.
What bike is this, Clayton?
It's a 200 XCW
2009. 2009 XCW 200.
Legend bike, but this one's a little bit of work.
It's gonna need some work.
But she's a good bike. We're gonna start her up a little bit before we drain the oil, though, to get it kind of warm.
We can hear the wheel bearing. I can hear it.
The front wheel bearing is bad. The rear top shock bearing is bad. Couple issues we're gonna have to go over.
This front wheel is a brand new tire, but the bearing's bad. You gotta replace that. I didn't notice this, but until now. But I realized that the fork seal is bad on both sides, so
we
do that.
TM, I have a KTM, so he wanted to ride together, of course, so we like 200s and 250s. So, need some work to fix her upper for sure, but we got a somewhat of a decent deal on it. We're gonna pop off this fuel tank and check out the subframe. So for some reason this top subframe bolt is not, just came loose.
Yeah, not fun.
So that's not a good thing.
But luckily it's not broke.
Not a huge thing. The frame looks pretty straight.
Nothing looks cracked or anything.
So we're just running this bolt back through here for the time being until we, it doesn't look like it's the correct bolt. It's definitely not the correct bolt, but we're going to just put that back through there for now until we find the right bolt. This back, or the top shock bearing is bad. You can tell that when you just pull up on the back wheel. If there's movement up here or at the bottom, you can tell where you're where it's bad at. So, let me see if I can hold this.
Yeah, I see.
Other than that, a bunch of little minor stuff. Fork seals. A little bit of an engine leak on the bottom. That's very, very minor. I don't think it's really even dropping. Kickstand's not jiggly too bad. These are rebuildable. Like, there's guts in here. You can pull them apart. There's an O-ring and stuff, so it's not too bad.
We got the oil all drained out right now, and there's two oil drain plugs. There's one on this side right down there by the brake, and then one right over here by your shift lever. Right down there.
And how do you tell when it's full?
Right by your brake lever, right in between there, there's a little hex nut right there, and that's your oil fill level check. And you just loosen that up till it drains.